Okay, the next step in the examination of the anterior chest regarding the respiratory system is the palpation. Really, in the palpation, first of all, we should ask the patient about any area of pain, and if present or if not, we can check it with each zone. Really, how can we know the zones of the chest? The zones of the chest can be obtained anteriorly via the following points: the sternal angle and the second rib here and here. What is above it is the upper zone. From the upper zone up to the fourth rib is the middle zone. From the middle zone to the sixth rib or to below is the lower zone. So we have upper zones, middle zones, and the lower zones. I'll ask the patient about any pain. أكو أي وجع بصدرك؟ أوكي هنا ما عندك؟ هنا ما عندك؟ وهنا أنا؟ أوكي وهنا؟ ولا هنا؟ أكو أوكي. So there is no pain. This is just to detect whether there is any pain and tenderness or not. After that you have to check for the apex speed. You have to localize it. Really in the examination of the precordium we had already described this issue. Really, this is the apex speed, and one should count from the sternal angle here and to check whether it is displaced or not. After the apex speed, one should check for the axillary lymphadenopathy. We had already examined this during the general examination. The left arm of the patient, I'll hold it by left arm, and I'll examine by my right arm the lateral group, the anterior group, the posterior group, lateral group, and deeply inside is the central group. The same thing I can apply it also, or should be applied anteriorly, checking for the or the right side, checking for the anterior group, posterior group, lateral and central group. After that, really one should check for the trachea. Trachea also had been examined or described in the general examination, either by this maneuver or by this maneuver, and we have to know that the trachea is centrally located and slightly to the right. After that, I'll ask the patient to sit, to check for the tracheal tag in the following manner. I'll put my finger between suprasternal notch and the cricoid cartilage, and to see the cricoid cartilage, how much it descends with the inspiration. Really, if the cricoid cartilage, the distance between the cricoid cartilage and the suprasternal notch is less than 4 or 3 finger, this indicates that the patient is dyspneic and this distance is shorter than usual. After that, I'll check for the vocal frumentus and check the chest expansion. Vocal frumentus really is a vibratory sensation felt over the chest, and what is important in the vocal frumentus is to know whether it is unilaterally or just one side it is diminished or increased while the contralateral side is normal. This is very important. That's to say, or in other words, you have to know that the abnormality in the vocal frumentus is just when it is unilateral. Bilaterally, it is very difficult to know it is increased or it is decreased, because you may need for a normal person. In the following manner, I'll check for vocal frumentus. I'll use my palmar side, especially the base of the finger, in such a manner. First of all, at the apex or at the upper zone. And I'll ask the patient to say 44 in Arabic. كل 44.
44.
هسه.
44.
هسه. 44. Okay. I'll check upper axillary zone. 44. Lower axillary zone.
44.
Okay. If any area is reduced, can be clinically very significant. If it is decreased or increased as compared with the contralateral side. After that, I'll check for expansion of the chest. I'll check the expansion here with a tape measure. while in the lower part of the chest. I'll check it with a bare hands. Okay, ما عاد بس تسمع لنا. هسه دب النفس، حيل حيل دب النفس. اوكي، خذ نفس كلش قوي. عشت ايدك. اوكي. على راحتك تنفس، على راحتك. Okay, so we obtained 101 while at the expansion it was 93. Okay, it was 93. So the difference between expansion, between the expiration and inspiration is 8 cm, which is the normal. Normally the expansion should be more than 8 cm. It is about more than 5 cm. It is about 5 to 8 cm. If it is less than 5 cm, it's probably abnormal, while if the chest is expanding less than 2 cm, it is definitely abnormal. After that, I'll check for the chest expansion also at the lower part of the chest by using my both hand. I'll put it at the lower part of the chest and approximating my thumbs in the midline slightly above the chest of the patient, and I'll ask him to expire and then to inspire. دب دب النفس دب. عفية. هسا خذ نفس كلش قوي. هاي عشت ايدك. So then we can measure this area from here to here. It is also about 7 to 8 cm, which is normal. Really, this is about the chest expansion. One should also in the chest expansion, one should look at the expansion, whether there is unilateral or bilateral decrease in the chest expansion. Really all these issues is about the palpation of the chest.